This is Tuesday. How you doing? All right, we're here in my office on Friday taping these things and looking ahead and seeing what God has got planned for us. So we're going to look at the last king of Israel before Assyria takes him away. That is Old Testament survey. In other words, here we go. Remember, I've been telling you that Israel split and that weakens them. And the kings of the north really, really struggled to do what was right in the eyes of the Lord. And so they got taken first. Judah was more up and down. They had good kings, but eventually Judah got taken away by Babylon. So a few random facts. When a male penguin falls in love with a female penguin, he presents her with a pebble from the beach. Now, I didn't know that. Most of these things, I don't. How are you supposed to know that? Cheeriophobia. Do you know what that is? Cheeriophobia. I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. C-H-E-R-O. I'm thinking, cheerio. Cheerophobia is probably another way. Is the fear of fun. I know those people. Yeah. An eagle can kill a young deer and fly away with it. Remember, some of these have wings 8 feet. 8 feet. Eagles, something else. So we're back to 2 Kings 17. 2 Kings. Verse 1, in the 12th year of Ahaz, king of Judah. So see how they give you, okay, Ahaz was reigning in Judah, and it was in his 12th year. Hoshea, son of Elah, became king of Israel in Samaria, and he reigned 9 years. Listen to this. He did evil in the eyes of the Lord, but not like the kings of Israel who preceded them. In other words, he was a little better. Shalmaneser, king of Assyria, came up to attack Hoshea, who had been Shalmaneser's vassal, and paid him tribute. But the king of Assyria discovered that Hoshea was a traitor, for he had sent envoys to So, king of Egypt. Can you imagine that? So, who's your king? So? Well, so what? No, So is our king. So? I mean, that could go on forever. So, S-O, king of Egypt, and he no longer paid tribute to king of Assyria, as he had done year by year. Therefore, Shalmaneser seized him and put him in prison. The king of Assyria invaded the entire land, marched against Samaria, and laid siege to it for 3 years. In the 9th year of Hoshea, the king of Assyria captured Samaria and deported the Israelites to where? To Assyria. He settled them in Hala and Gozan on the Habor River and in the towns of the Medes. All this took place, listen to this, all this took place because the Israelites had sinned against the Lord their God, who had brought them up out of Egypt from under the power of Pharaoh the king. They worshipped other gods and followed the practices of the nations the Lord had driven out before them, as well as the practices that the kings of Israel had introduced. The Israelites secretly did things against the Lord their God that were not right. From watchtower to fortified city, they built themselves high places in all the towns. They set up sacred stones and Asherah poles on every high hill and under every spreading tree. At every high place, they burned incense, as the nations whom the Lord had driven out before them had done. They did wicked things that aroused the Lord's anger. They worshipped idols. The Lord had said, "Do not do this." The Lord warned Israel and Judah through all of his prophets and seers, "Turn from your evil ways, observe my commands and decrees in accordance with the entire law that I commanded your ancestors to obey, and that I delivered to you through my servants the prophets." But they would not listen and were stiff-necked as their ancestors, who did not trust in the Lord their God. They rejected his decrees and the covenant he made with their ancestors and the statutes he had warned to them. They followed worthless idols and themselves became worthless. Oh, this is 2 Kings 17. I hope you read it again. I hope you understand. It's not as if they you know, played video games too long. It wasn't as if they ate too much sugar that day. It wasn't that instead of having two old fashions, they had three. No, they were intentionally going against God at every juncture, at every stage of their life. If they had done opposite day, they'd have been fine. You know, they tear down the high places. They got rid of the Asherah pole. They wouldn't have done evil in the sight of the Lord. But no, whatever the Lord said, they did the opposite of. If they'd done the opposite of what they thought they should do, then they would have been doing what the Lord wanted them to do. So it's sad, sad, sad business. These are God's people. They had the scrolls. They had things written down by God. They had the Pentateuch. They knew about Moses and them coming out of Egypt. They knew these stories well, and yet they went after idols. And notice this, worthless idols, and they themselves became worthless, because you're no higher, you're no higher, your status in life. When I say status, I mean the right kind of status. Your status in life is worthless if you're following worthless idols. You may be wearing a $5,000 suit. You may be driving a $250,000 car and have a house in France, a house in South, they tell me the Cape is real beautiful. So you got a house there and you got a house here in the United States in Beverly Hills. Who knows? It doesn't matter. You have become worthless because you're worshiping things that are transient, that aren't going to last. And so this is the whole nation. And it mainly was because of the kings. The kings set the tone. So you as parents, if you're a parent, are setting the tone. If you go off to work and you're a manager, assistant manager, owner, you know, you have some title, you're setting a pace, you're setting the tone. Even you say, well, I don't do any of that. I don't have any title. I, quote unquote, I'm just a worker bee. You're still setting a tone. And so do what's right in the eyes of the Lord, follow him, and know that blessings will come your way. I'm going to get back in Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy is so good. He says, you do these things, and he names them. You follow the Lord, you do his decrees, you stay in step with God, blessings will come your way. Then he sits down, he goes, however, if you go against God, and you do what is wicked, and you deny his word, these things will come upon you. And he lays before them a covenant choice. Which are you going to follow? And you can see here, the Israelites did not follow the Lord. And that's in every human being. We're free agents. We're free agents. We're in bondage. I mean, gravity's got us, all that. However, we still are capable of choosing. And that is very powerful on our behalf, that we can choose by the power of the Holy Spirit to do what is right. And that will always turn out good for us and those around us. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord, help us not to be like the Israelites and King Joash and these kings before him. Help us, Lord, to follow you with a whole heart. Help us, Lord, to know our limitations and just how desperately we need you. In Jesus' name, amen.